Windows Universe, Michael with the Windows Club, spitting a verse that will leave you wowed with knowledge and ready to bust a move on malware thugs. In this video, we will look at the SMB port and why it is important. We'll also talk about port 445 and port 139. It's a lot of ground to cover, so we're also going to link an article in the description that will go even further into depth. SMB stands for Service Message Blocks, in modern coding language, but also known as Internet File System. The system operates as an application layer network protocol, primarily used for offering shared access to files, printers, serial ports, and other sorts of communication between nodes on a network. For the most part, usage of SMB involves computers running Microsoft Windows, where it was known as Microsoft Windows Network before the introduction of Active Directory. It can run on top of the session network in multiple ways. For instance, SMB can run directly over TCP IP without the need for NetBIOS, and this will use port 445. On other systems, you will find services and applications using port 139. This all ties into NetBIOS, or Network Basic Input-Output System. It is a software protocol that allows applications, PCS, and desktops on a local area network to communicate with network hardware and to transit data across the network. Software applications that run on a NetBIOS network locate and identify each other through their NetBIOS names. When two applications start a NetBIOS session, one computer, or the client, sends a command call to the other computer, the server, over TCP port 139. NetBIOS on your wide area network or internet is at an enormous security risk. All sorts of vital information such as your domain, your workgroup, system names, as well as your account information can be obtained via NetBIOS. This makes an effective firewall essential, since, as a safety measure, a firewall blocks this port first. It'll also be used for file and printer sharing, and once exposed, it opens your hard disk to attack by a hacker. Once in an active 139 port, a hacker can take simple steps to obtain critical information about you and your computer. Then, port 445 is deeply embedded in Windows, and it's hard to close safely, but closure is possible. That's dependent of the DHCP, or the Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Malicious hackers admit that port 445 is vulnerable and has many insecurities. One example is the silent appearance of NetBIOS worms. These worms slowly and methodically scan the internet for instances of port 445, they transfer themselves to the new victim computer, and then redouble their scanning. It's a chilling thought that there are massive bot armies containing tens and thousands of NetBIOS worms compromised machines inhabit the internet. And that is why many ISPs feel it's necessary to block this port on behalf of its users. Now, have you encountered problems with security in ports 139 and 445? Let us know in the comments down below. And for more factoids about Windows 10, visit us at thewindowsclub.com. And if you found this video informative, give it a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe, where we are always adding new videos to make your digital world safe and secure. Thanks for watching and have a great day.